going to engage you in an activity that is related to the speech, which is maybe it will also include some stressing exercises also with some pronunciation exercises, and it is a part of actually effective communication subject. But since I am not prepared for your current affair and I have not made the slides for you, so I'll not take up right now that topic. So let me start with my slideshow, which I want to show you, and it is going to be a fun activity with you all. I know that you all are in, you know, you are good orators. I have not heard any of you, but still I can make sure that you are one. Okay, one second. Again, there is a problem here. I've not opened it properly. Okay. Here we go. I've not shared the screen. Let me just share it also with you people. So now here you can see some slide on the screen. Is it visible? Okay. So this is like, how does pronunciation, punctuation matter? Then also I am going to take up pronunciation. P-R-O-N-O-U-N, pronunciation. Okay. Pronunciation, punctuation and stress, all these things are very important part of speech. Why? Because once any of these things, they change in a sentence, the meaning totally changes. Okay. There, you must have heard of certain words like homophones, homographs. So when the homophones, they have the similar sound, but once you write and you write wrong spelling, the whole meaning changes. So that's why. So if you can see this caricature, when they say apostrophe is here and there is no comma here, okay, so that means let's eat grandma. So grandma is in the plate and we have to eat her. So the whole meaning changes. Actually, what was actually meant, so they were calling, let's eat grandma. So means they were calling grandma. So punctuation matters. So there was no comma here, so that means this figure, let's eat grandma. All right, now eat your dinner, that means it's so simple. But if you put here, you are dinner, if you put an apostrophe here, the whole meaning changes. Eat, and yahan pe they had put one full stop, that means eat, you are dinner, that means you have to be eaten. All right, now if I say 20, that means 25 dollars bill, 25. How does this come out to be 100? Because it's a 25 dollars bill, and here there is an hyphen here, $25 bill. That means here it is 25 dollars ke 20 bills. All right, so $5 ke 20 bills means 5 into 20 is equal to $100. The whole meaning changes if the hyphen is in the wrong place. You understood? So you have to take care of all these things when you are, whether you are writing, and while you are speaking, you have to stress at a proper place. All right, moving ahead, there are some more examples like this. I want to thank my parents Tiffany and God. So here means she wants to thank whom? Tiffany, parents and God. That means there are three people she wants to thank, or he wants to thank. But here I want to thank my parents. That means who are the parents? Tiffany and God. Oh no, sorry. So here it means that way. Tiffany and God are the parent. And here I want to thank my parents, Tiffany and God. Here, because they have put one extra comma here, that means she wants to the parents are Tiffany and God. So you will make sure that you want to separate all the common nouns and proper noun with a comma. Then it makes sense. Otherwise, if you don't put here I think there has to be a semicolon. There is a mistake here. That is why I think I was also confused. There is a mistake here. So you will be take here it is colon. My parents, Tiffany and God. So that means that who are the parents? Tiffany and God. So man eating chicken. This man eating chicken. Man is eating a chicken. So that means it's very normal. But here if I put a hyphen here, that means the chicken is devouring the man. Chicken eating. Chicken is something that is a man eating chicken. So hyphen at a proper place gives you the proper meaning what you want to convey. Otherwise the whole meaning changes. Now I find inspiration in cooking my family and my dog. Okay, so what does she cook? Her family and the dog. Okay, they are all in the frying pan. So here if the comma is in the proper and all the common noun and the collective noun like my family, they are separated with a comma, so the meaning is clear. That means there are three things that she find inspiration or pleasure in. These are the three: cooking, family and dog. So here when there is no comma in between, that means she finds inspiration in cooking, her family and dog. So you have to be very careful where you have to put the comma, otherwise the whole meaning will change. And your since you will be into media, you don't want people to take you for these gaffes and all, faux pas. Okay, next. This is my favorite. A woman without her man is nothing. That means she is a woman with no man in her life, so she's looking so gloomy and sad. So that means a woman without her man is nothing. That means she needs her husband or a partner who is a man. But here it's a winning statement. A woman, who is she? Without her man is nothing. That means man needs a woman. Here this woman is so independent and so bubbly, so nice, that without her man is nothing. So this is for a class of, means for all the women. This is for a one woman. Okay, so when one woman, she's looking so desperate, gloomy and vulnerable, that means she's incomplete without her man. But here it's for a class of women, all those women, that means who are very strong, independent, have got a poise and all. So that means without her man is nothing. So which statement do you believe in? I'm sure the second one, because women is empowered now. Women for man actually is nothing without women. We both are complementary to each other. It goes the same way around for man also. Women need men, men need women. So both of them complement each other. So let's move ahead. So first thing I said, punctuation matters. So when punctuation was here and there, so the whole meaning changes. Now the stress also, not only punctuation, where you are stressing, that is also a very important thing. Okay, rat eating cat. Rat eating cat, or a cat which is a rat eating. So how will you stress? Rat eating cat. Rat eating cat. So the stress changes, the meaning changes. So when you are speaking, you will not be able to see the pronunciation, punctuation marks, sorry. So when you are speaking, you won't be able to recognize the punctuation marks. Only the thing that is visible is the stress in the speech. So where you stress, the meaning changes. Now here I have given you certain one sentence only in many different way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So in 8 different ways the stress is changed, and once the stress is changed, the meaning changes. Okay, should I speak these sentences, or you will speak in your mind? Just stress on the yellow thing and then you will see how the meaning changes. For example, here you will put a stress on I, here you will put a stress on didn't, here you will put a stress on say, in this sentence you will put a stress on you, here you will put a stress on stole, here my, and then red, and then hat. I'll tell you. I didn't say you stole my hoard. That means somebody else said. That means you are putting a stress on I. I didn't say you stole my hat, red hat. Second, I didn't say you stole my hat. That means I said something else. I didn't say you stole my hat, red hat. So that means you did something else. You didn't say anything. You said you did something else. I didn't say. That means maybe you assumed. I didn't say you stole my red hat. That means it's not you. Somebody else stole the red hat. I didn't say you stole my red hat. That means maybe I said you borrowed my red hat. I didn't say you stole. You kept it somewhere else or something else. So the stress changes the meaning. Now putting stress on my. I didn't say you stole my red hat. That means you stole somebody else's red hat. Right? Now here, red ke upar stress. I didn't say you stole my red hat. That means you stole some other hat, maybe yellow hat or a white hat. Now here, I didn't say you stole my red hat. That means it is not the hat, something else, maybe scarf or maybe gloves. So I didn't say you stole my red hat. It may be, I didn't say you stole my red scarf, something else. So you saw how the meaning changes once you putting the stress on a different word, and the meaning totally changes. Altogether. So moving ahead, there are some more exercises here. These are some commonly wrong pronounced words in English. Okay. So let me give you a chance one by one. So in case you know the meaning, and I'm going to put a tick mark over here. So let me know what is the correct pronunciation of the first word. If anybody knows. Please unmute. Yeah. Most of the people, they try to pronounce each syllable differently. And they say wet, then ness, and then day. And this is a wrong way. The correct pronunciation of this word is Wednesday. Wednesday. Okay? The correct pronunciation is Wednesday. This D is not there. So we have to combine these two into Wednesday. Anybody tell me the pronunciation of this word? Yeah. So, please, what's your name? Acha, I did not hear your name properly. Maybe the speaker is not on a full volume. So, the correct pronunciation of this word is not almond. It's wrong. The correct pronunciation is almond. So this L is not to be pronounced. The correct pronunciation is almond. Similarly, there's one more word which is very common, and that is, I think I have not put in the list, but that is people say it is asthma. It is, this TH is not to be pronounced. The correct pronunciation is asthma. I'm suffering from asthma. Okay, the correct pronunciation. But in case you have two people in India, most of them, they go by each, you know, pronouncing each and every letter in the word, but the correct pronunciation is asthma. But we all say asthma. So that is it. Now, next, who is going to unmute and tell me what is the correct pronunciation of this word? Yeah. No, itinerary is wrong. If you say itinerary, it is wrong. The correct pronunciation is itinerary. So itinerary, ठीक है? It is I. It नहीं बोलना है इसको, ठीक है? Itinerary. Now, what is this? Anybody knows? Just now, I think in this lecture only I use this. Okay, this is faux pas. The correct pronunciation is faux pas. Mostly when we see this word, we always try to say it like fox pass, which is wrong. And what is the meaning? Anybody knows the meaning of this word? It's basically a type of a embarrassing moment or a embarrassing error in public, or a blunder, like behavioral gaffe. Sometimes, you know, people, they burp in the public or fart in the public, so it becomes a faux pas. Okay, or they say something which is very like very funny, so that becomes a faux pas. Okay, it's a behavioral gaffe. Now, what is the pronunciation of this word? Please unmute and very nice. The correct pronunciation is gauge. People say gauge because they go by gauge. This is wrong. The answer that you said is correct. It's gauge. I want to gauge your strength. I want to gauge. Now, what is the correct pronunciation of this word? People say pitch, you know, here, you know, R is not to be pronounced. ठीक है? Most of the words in the English language, in the end, when there is a R, most of the time R has to be dropped. ठीक है? Here also, some people say picture. They pronounce it like this, picture. This is wrong. Okay, this has to be pronounced like picture, or better, you put K. So this will give you this. These are the correct sound, correct you know, pronunciation on this side, and this side I am writing the wrong one. So the correct one is picture. Did you go for the picture? Sure. So R has to be dropped. Okay. Alright, now what is the correct pronunciation of this word? This one. Yeah, the correct answer is debut. It is to be pronounced this way. Debut. I am trying to make it correct. People say debut. Some people, they do it. So don't mind some people, because it's all the matter of exposure. The more you have been hearing the language from BBC and other channels, so you will get to know the correct pronunciation. But in case you are following some people who are having the wrong pronunciation, you will follow that. There's nothing wrong. Even at this age of 47, I have corrected myself for so many words. Okay, I'll tell you one of the incidents. There was a story of Don. Abhi, this I'm not going to speak, because this is something, the most mispronounced word or proper noun. So my I had this story of Don. This one I'm not deliberately saying the word, because this was wrong pronounced and how it got corrected after 20 years. So my first lecturer, not lecturer, when I was in 7th grade, okay, I was in Assam at that time. I am one student of Akkavian. So my first teacher, English teacher, who had to tell me the pronunciation, he gave me the correct pronunciation. I'm telling you, he gave me the correct one. And he gave me, this was the correct. So, but when the same chapter came in, I think, 11th standard, sometime there are repetition of a chapter, or maybe not in the English, maybe it was there in another subject or something. So the second teacher gave me the pronunciation, Don Quickstow. Quickstow. This was the pronunciation he gave me. The first one gave me the correct, you know, I'm telling you, the first one gave me the correct. But since I was not sure whether this is correct or not, I was always confused. Because at that very point of time also, there was another teacher who gave me another pronunciation which I have forgotten. So I was a bit confused what is the correct one. So in 11th standard, when I actually, you know, I was in a KVN school, so my father was in a transferable job. So that time I was in Assam. So the teacher from Assam actually gave me the correct pronunciation. But now when in 11th standard, I was in Kanpur KV. So the teacher who was in Kanpur gave me a wrong pronunciation for the same word. Now, maze ki baat hai, when I was in was doing my graduation, now the same thing came again. Can you imagine this first, second term and third time this came again? Same word, Don Kyoto. So third time my graduation ka jo professor tha, that person again gave me the same thing. And you know, the correct pronunciation, now without telling you anything, the correct pronunciation of this word is Don Quixote. Nobody can imagine, because it was not matching with this. So I was confused ki how can it be Quixote. It is actually Quixote, Don Quixote. Okay, now maze ki baat, first incident, second incident, third incident. Now the fourth incident with the same word was when my son was in, he was in Don Bosco Matunga. Now one of the English teacher had this chapter of Don Quixote. So she said Don Quickstow. Again some cute. Huh. She said Don Quixote. 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 Now look at the same word, how it is like everybody is pronouncing apne maze se, koi kuch bol raha hai, koi kuch bol raha hai. So when I was in Assam, when I was in 7th standard, that was the year 1986, or I think something, I don't remember, but it was the year 1986. Things were very difficult to get the correct pronunciation at that time. So I had to, you know, only rely on my teacher. The other teacher was telling different, so I was confused. At when I came to 7th, so again I got confused what is the correct word. So I used to, you know, actually fear this word. Whenever it used to come, I used to like mammal karke nikal jana kar, because we don't know what is the correct pronunciation. Now when my son was in Don Bosco, he was in 7th, 6th or whatever standard, when the same word came, we had Google Baba, right? Now when you have a Google Baba in your house and you know the correct pronunciation is at your fingertip, all those Britishers with Emma Singh karke ek hai website, Emma Singh karke, it's a YouTube, wherever you know you have a problem with certain word, that how to pronounce it, so you go to Emma Singh and type that word and you will get the correct pronunciation. So when my son was in this was in a fix what to pronounce, so we again searched and we found that my first professor was the correct. He was always right, and even my graduation wala professor was right. So now I got to know that this is the correct pronunciation, but it took a long time. You people are very, very, very lucky. Why I'm saying you are lucky? You know why? Because you have everything at your fingertip. You don't have to bother and wait for so many years to get the correct pronunciation of a word, and you don't have to fear that word. कि इफ इट कम्स इन यू नो फॉर मी टू प्रोनाउंस इफ आई गो रॉन्ग व्हाट विल हैपन. यू डोंट हैव टू वरी एट ऑल. ओके सो नेक्स्ट वर्ड आई गिव यू अ वेरी लॉन्ग स्टोरी बट द नेक्स्ट वर्ड इज हु विल टेल मी द वर्ड करेक्ट. हाँ सो दिस इज अगेन वी ऑल मेक मिस्टेक. इवन यू हैव मेड द मिस्टेक. यू सेड एक्स प्रेसो. सो द करेक्ट इज नॉट एक्सप्रेसो इट इज एस्प्रेसो. वॉट इज द करेक्ट? एस्प्रेसो. वी विल नॉट प्रोनाउंस दिस. इट विल बी प्रोनाउंस एज एस एस्प्रेसो. ओके मूविंग अहेड वी हैव लॉन्ग लिस्ट. हाँ नाउ वॉट इज द करेक्ट प्रोनाउंसिएशन ऑफ दिस वर्ड? हु विल टेल मी? There is not much difference between the correct pronunciation and the wrongly pronounced word because here you know you don't have to just ignore this e and you have to say sp and then stress on si which is this is ci and then you have to say fic specific. So basically you don't have to stress here specific. Yahan pe jo a ka stress aa raha hai na a e ka that you don't have to do. It's basically specific. Specific. Got it? Don't say specific. People try to हम लोगों का है हम मेरी भी गलती है. Even I have learned you know even I am learning at this age also. Sometime I even now sometimes some word comes and I am in a fix like how to pronounce it. So here we don't have to stress on this vowel. It has to be basically ignored. ठीक है? Specific. Now what is the correct pronunciation of this word? Epitome. Yeah, it is not epitome. We all say, even I used to say epitome. Epitome is not right. We have to epitome. Epitome. So these are, I am breaking them into syllables. You see, if I am putting a hyphen here, that means I am breaking the word into syllables. You know what is a syllable? That means in how many parts the pronunciation of the word can be broken into. Epitome. It is epitome. Okay? Now, what is the correct pronunciation of this word? No. Everybody, even I used to think this is suit. This is not suit. It has to be pronounced as sweet. Okay? It has to be pronounced as sweet. आपने होटेल्स के रूम देखे हैं? The rooms which has got you know double one hall room and then you go inside, then you have a bath and then you have another thing. So that means more than one single room, then it is called a hotel suite. Never called it suit. Okay? It has to be pronounced as sweet. Now, what is the pronunciation of this word? Yeah, it is not P has to be dropped, okay? The correct, it is not like coop. This is wrong. P has to be dropped. You will say, you take K because K sound gives you. The correct pronunciation is coop. Next word? Yeah, everybody knows. But some people who are very ignorant, they sometimes get confused because there is UE and UE, so they say QUE. I've heard those, huh? Don't laugh because I've heard that also, QUE. People have been saying. The answer is, correct answer is Q. Okay? Now, correct pronunciation of this word?
Chaos.
Some people, who have not been exposed, they say chaos. Chase, chores, I don't know, so many, you know, people are there. Because you all are exposed, so you know it is chaos. I'm sorry, I have to write chaos. Chaos. Okay? Now, what is the correct pronunciation of this word? Yeah. But again, I said R has to be dropped. You don't have to pronounce the R. It automatically anybody who hears you will understand there is a R. Humor. The correct answer is humor. Humor. Okay. What is the correct pronunciation for this word? This is boutique. Boo and then teak. This is the correct. Boutique. Okay. Shall we move ahead? Okay. What is the correct pronunciation of this word? Isle. People get confused because there is a S here. Some people say azel. Azel. I've heard that. So don't laugh also, because you don't have to, because they have not been hearing this word. They have not been exposed. Once, exposure is very important. The more you hear, the more people, reading se nahi aate. Pronunciation will never come from reading. You know, in reading, you have different symbols like these and these. But that was an olden time when Daniel wrote a book about the how to pronounce a word. Because at that time we did not have those hearing devices like abhi to hamare Google mein jao, you have this mic thing na, and then just press this and you can hear that word and you grab that pronunciation ki kya pronunciation hai and you try to follow that. But 1910 mein when he wrote this book, there was no such hearing devices and mic and all, so he gave those symbol aise karke. These were the symbols, all these symbols were given. So when this comes, you have to pronounce it like this, or this comes, you have to pronounce it like this. Okay? Now, this also. Often. Because here also some people say often. This is wrong. Now, what is the correct pronunciation for this word? Again, you have to drop this R. R is not to be pronounced. It is archive. Archive. Okay? And this will come with practice, Archive. So, even if you don't use this word R, your pronunciation is almost similar to archive. Isn't it? So, try to drop this R here and say archive. Archive. Now, what is the correct pronunciation for this one? यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा हम लोग करते हैं mischievous. V-S. ऐसे कर देते हैं हम लोग. Mischievous. V-S नहीं करना है. हमको क्या करना है? Mischievous. ठीक है? V-S नहीं करना है. We have to say mischievous. That boy is so mischievous. Mischievous नहीं करना है हमको. ये ना, जब भी दो two vowels when they come together, they are called diphthong. Okay, when they come together, sometimes they have to be pronounced separately, दोनों को. But sometimes they are totally different from what they actually have to be. Here it is the same case. It is vs. V O भी नहीं आएगा, U भी नहीं आएगा. It is to be replaced by. It is only to be only O has to be removed. It is vs. Mischievous. Now, what is the correct pronunciation for this one? Athlete नहीं है. It is not a. हम लोग क्या करते हैं? Athlete बोलते हैं. It is athlete. Athlete. Okay? Athlete. Now, what is the correct pronunciation for this one? Forte. Forte. The correct pronunciation is forte. Okay? Now, this is very important. It seems very, यहाँ पे आपका थोड़ा सा मिस्टेक आ गया. आप क्या कर रहे हो? इसको स बोल रहे हो. ठीक है, इसको हमको क्या बनाना है? ज. ठीक है, क्या बनाएंगे? अभी भी यहाँ पे ओ आ रहा है आपका. ये ओ को हटाएंगे, ओ नहीं आना है, स भी नहीं आना है. आंसर इज क्लोथ्स. क्लोथ्स. ओ की जगह ओ लाना है. क्या लाना है? ओ की जगह ओ, और यहाँ पे स की जगह ज लाना है. ज. क्लोथ्स, ये एक्चुअली हो जाता है थ, बिकॉज वेन एवर थ साउंड इज फॉलोड बाय एस इट हैज टू बी प्रोनाउंस विद एस, ये एक रूल याद रख लेना, ठीक है, इट इज टू बी प्रोनाउंस्ड एज ज, ठीक है. एंड हियर देर इज वन ई विच इज साइलेंट, इस ई को क्लोथ्स करने की जरूरत नहीं है, यहाँ पे ई को स्ट्रेस भी नहीं देना है, ठीक है. ऑलराइट, सो दिस लुक्स वेरी कॉमन बट दिस हैज गॉट मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल दे टेंड टू मेक मिस्टेक हियर. इट इज नॉट क्लॉथ्स, इट इज नॉट क्लोथ्स, इट इज क्लोथ्स. ओके, नेक्स्ट वर्ड कैलेंडर. कैलेंडर, हु गेव द कैलेंडर? या दैट इज राइट, आई सेड ना र को वी हैव टू ड्रॉप दिस र, सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज कै एल यू एच ल कैलेंडर. दिस इज द करेक्ट, जो मैं यहां पे आपको लिख रही हूं दीज आर द करेक्ट वन. हा, कै लर्न द कैलेंडर, तो र नहीं मैंने डाला, हैव आई पुट र हियर? नो. Even if you don't say ra, the pronunciation is correct. So don't have to stress on this. हम लोग because हम लोग हिंदी पढ़ते हैं, अब हमारी मातृभाषा हिंदी है, so हिंदी में क्या होता है, एक एक शब्द का उच्चारण बहुत अच्छे से करते हैं हम लोग, एक चीज़ को भी ड्रॉप नहीं किया जाता है. But English is not that way. English is a totally different language. And in fact, I always insert a clip of there is an old movie. उसका बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग सा क्लिप आता है जिसमें अमिताभ बच्चन है ना, अमिताभ बच्चन, धर्मेंद्र एंड शर्मिला टैगोर एंड डेविड, इनका एक बहुत अच्छा सा मूवी है जिसमें वो जी ओ गो एंड टी ओ टू, तो वाई जी ओ गो होता है एंड जी ओ गू क्यों नहीं होता है. सो दैट इज़ अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग क्लिप. अभी मुझे कट करने का टाइम नहीं मिला था बिकॉज आई जस्ट वॉज टोल्ड लास्ट नाइट दैट आई हैव टू टेक दिस क्लास. सो हिंदी को हम लोग एक एक वर्ड को, एक एक शब्द को अच्छे से उच्चारण करते हैं उसका, बट इन इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज इट इज़ नॉट दैट वे. वी हैव टू फॉलो बिकॉज दैट्स द नॉर्म, बिकॉज अदरवाइज वॉट विल हैपन. अभी देखो मैंने बिकॉज बोला, सॉरी बिकॉज, अभी पीपल से बिकॉज, इट इज़ नॉट बिकॉज, इट इज़ बिकॉज. यू हैव टू प्रोनाउंस इट एज बी कज, बिकॉज, because we have to go by the correct pronunciation. We have actually, to be very frank, Indians are best, you know, as far as pronunciation is concerned. Abhi maine word bola pronunciation, even this word, this word, if I say na pronunciation, even this word is pronounced very wrongly. You know why? Because we tend to make it from the word pronouns. Pronouns, इसमें diphthong आ गया, देखो O and U दोबारा से इकट्ठा हो गया, मैंने जो बोला था ना. So क्या होता है, pronouns ऐसे करके बोला, but यहाँ पे क्या होगा, ये अ हो जाएगा, हम लोग बोलेंगे pronunciation नहीं बोलेंगे, we'll say pronunciation. Actually में इसका pronunciation क्या हो जाएगा, pronunciation, ठीक है. सो ये चीज़ें आपको ओनली प्रैक्टिस से आएंगी, एंड आफ्टर हियरिंग बीबीसी एंड ऑल दोज न्यूज़ चैनल्स हु आर यू नो वेरी गुड इन इंग्लिश, देन यू विल बी एबल टू क्रिएट एन इम्पैक्ट इन योर स्पीच. एंड इट इज़ नथिंग रॉन्ग, यू हैव टू लर्न, यू नो ऑफ कोर्स इफ यू आर स्पीकिंग इन अ वेरी गुड, यू नो विद यू वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट एन इम्पैक्ट, यू विल डेफिनेटली put the stress in a proper place, you will have a good pronunciation, you will choose your words wisely, hai na? Since you are going into media field, you have to be a good orator. Even if you don't want to go into media field, you, if you want to win friends, if you want that your speech should have an impact, you will definitely put, you know, some effort in this direction. Okay, abhi direction bola maine word, if I said direction, people tend to say direction, it is not direction, it is direction, ठीक है. सो इट विल कम विद प्रैक्टिस, डोंट हैव टू वरी एट ऑल, बिकॉज इट टेक्स प्रैक्टिस विल मेक यू परफेक्ट. नाउ दिस इज अनदर वर्ड आई थिंक. या इट्स अबाउट टाइम टू वाइंड अप द क्लास. नो नो आई स्टिल I still have five or ten minutes. Okay, so I am actually enjoying teaching you this. So let me finish with this. What is the correct pronunciation for this one? It is not kernel. It is not kernel. People say kernel, or people say colonel. Colonel. It is kernel. Kernel. Okay. Next is, this is very common word, but still people tend to make mistake. Because anybody can tell me the correct pronunciation for this word? Yeah, you are right. Congrats. I have taken it right. Congrats. People say congrats, which is wrong. Congrats is wrong. Con nahi bolna, isko congrats. Congrats. ठीक है. What is the correct pronunciation for this one? Yes. K. Bird. This is H. K. Bird. People tend to say cupboard. Yeah. There are people who there nothing wrong because they go by each and every letter. As per the Hindi, so they say cupboard or kabad, something, some, hana, and some people say cupboard. So this don't have to say that way. You say cupboard. Now, what is the correct pronunciation for this one? Yeah, debris. People say debris. Debris. This is wrong. S ko pronounce nahi karna hai aur D ko bhi aise nahi karna hai. It has to be very subtle. Debris. It has to be pronounced like debris. Okay. Now this one, genre is wrong. Genre. The correct is genre. No, actually genre. तो H लगाया तो genre हो गया. Genre. The correct pronunciation is genre. It is not genre, genre, all these are wrong. The correct one is genre, genre. ठीक है. Next one, honor. मैंने बोला ना र को आपको ड्रॉप करना है, बोलना ही नहीं है. सो आप क्या बोलोगे? Honor. सो सिंपल ना. एच भी, ये वाला एच भी गया, ये भी गया. बेसिकली वो बेसिकली जो हम लोग प्रोनाउंस करते हैं ये करते हैं. ऑनर. ऑनर. ठीक है. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज हाँ, इनविटेशन इज करेक्ट. इन व, इसका करेक्ट प्रोनाउंसिएशन है इन व टे शन. ओके. इनविटेशन. पीपल टेंड टू से इनविटेशन. ओके. और क्या गलत होता है? आई डोंट नो. देर आर इन्विटेशन तो मैंने कई बार सुना है. सो दैट इज रॉन्ग. दिस इज इन्विटेशन. 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 नाउ वॉट इज दिस वर्ड? दिस आई एम श्योर. हाँ, यस, दिस इज ली एज. ली एज. एंड वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ड? Basically, to cooperate. Like for example, मैं बोलूँ आपको, you all liaise with me in today's session. That means you all cooperate with me, liaise with me. Okay. So people tend to make say liaise, lose, liaise. पता नहीं क्या क्या बोलते हैं. ठीक है, उनकी गलती नहीं है. And never make mock of anybody. Because हम लोग भी तो सीख रहे हैं. मैं भी तो सीख कर आई हूँ. अभी भी सीख रही हूँ. हो सकता है कई वर्ड अभी भी मेरे रॉन्ग हों जो आप लोग मुझे करेक्ट करो. And I'll be thankful for that. Because learning should never stop in your life. Even at this age, if I tell my dad that, daddy, this is wrong pronunciation, aap wrong karte ho. So he admits, he said, hum logon ne abhi tak yehi sikha hai. It's okay. नो नो, देर इज नो नथिंग कि आप रॉन्ग हो, रॉन्ग की बात नहीं है, आप सीख रहे हो, दैट इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट. ठीक है, लेट्स गो टू द नेक्स्ट वन. दिस इज, अरे वाह, यू ऑल ईट दिस. इट इज नॉट मेयोनीज. ठीक है, द करेक्ट इज मी अ नीज, मेयोनीज, मेयोनीज. इट इज नॉट मे, हम लोग मेयो बोलते हैं ना, दैट इज नॉट, हमको उसको नहीं करना है, इसको बोलना है मेयोनीज, मेयोनीज. ठीक है, इट इज मेयोनीज. नाउ नेक्स्ट वन, हाँ दिस इज राइट, मे न्यू, इसको न्यू के जैसे बोलना है, मे न्यू. सम पीपल कॉल इट मनू, मेनूज, सम पीपल कॉल इट मेनू और मेनूज. सो मनू सब, ये सब रॉन्ग हो जाएगा, हमको बोलना है मे न्यू, न्यू. नेक्स्ट इज नेक्स्ट वन, टेल मी. यस, सम पीपल टेंड टू थिंक दिस इज च एंड दे कॉल नीचे, नीच. द करेक्ट वन इज नीश. ओके, नीश. नेक्स्ट इज, यस, हियर द बी साउंड इज नॉट टू बी प्रोनाउंस्ड एट ऑल. इट इज नॉट टू बी, सम पीपल टेंड टू मेक इट इवन डबल, जो तो और भी गलती करते. जैसे प्लम्बर आ गया, प्लम्बर, दैट इज रॉन्ग. आपको अगर अभी आपने नया प्रोनाउंसिएशन सीखा है, सो वॉट यू विल डू, स्टार्ट टेलिंग पीपल कि दिस इज द करेक्ट वन. अगर वो नहीं मानते तो उनका मजाक नहीं उड़ाना है, अपना कहीं सही करते जाना है. वो धीरे धीरे आपको सुन के सही हो जाएंगे, नहीं होंगे तो इट्स ओके, डजेंट मैटर, बिकॉज यू आर इन टू मीडिया, यू डोंट हैव टू बी ऑन द रॉन्ग फुट. ओके, इफ दीज पीपल आर यू नो इग्नोरेंट, नॉन एडुकेटेड, दे आर मेकिंग मिस्टेक, लेट देम, डोंट ट्राई टू करेक्ट. Try to give them feedback in case they are very interested. Teach them in case they want to know. But in case they close the door, no, we don't want to know. So don't try to, you know, make mock of them. It is not plumber, plumber. It is plumber. Plumber. Okay? Now, ye word aage jo maine aapko bataya tha. So what is the correct? You have to ditch this O. ये जो O है ना, इसको ditch कर देना है, समझना है कि है ही नहीं. So you will get the correct answer. No, अभी तो मैंने बोला it has not to be said, noun नहीं बोलना है, noun नहीं बोलना है, इसको नन बोलना है. क्या बोलना है? Pronunciation. Pro भी नहीं बोलना है, pro भी नहीं बोलना है, pr बोलना है, pr nun C-A-T-I-O-N. This is the correct. Pronunciation. ठीक है? Noun नहीं बोलना है इसको. वैसे अगर आपके पास ये noun word अकेला आता है तो you have to say it noun. और अगर ये word आता है तो भी आपको pronounce बोलना है. Pronounce. But जब ये word आएगा तो आपको ओ को समझना है कि है ही नहीं, यहाँ पे समझ लो है ही नहीं, और ये भी ओ नहीं है, तो क्या बन गया? प्रोनंसिएशन. सो इसमें बोलते हैं डिच द ओ, डिच कर दो ओ को, धोखा दे दो कि तुम हो ही नहीं. ठीक है, पूरी तरह इग्नोर कर दो उसे. नाउ नेक्स्ट वर्ड, इट इज रॉन्देवू. रॉन्देवू, the correct is rendezvous. People tend to say this last wala x, then they also rendezvous karte hain, rendezvous bolte hain, rendezvous bhi wrong hai, it's actually rendezvous ka matlab hota hai face to face conversation. theek hai, what is this next word? quay, key. The correct pronunciation is key. Okay? People say quay and all so, sort of things. Quay is wrong. Some people say, because ye u aata na, so they, we think that this has to be pronounced. And we think this is going to be the way it is written. And maine bola, English language is such a language, it does not follow any rule. सो सबसे ज्यादा साइंटिफिक लैंग्वेज इन द वर्ल्ड इज संस्कृत. संस्कृत इज सबसे ज्यादा, आई डोंट नो मैं सही लिख रही हूँ कि नहीं, ऐसे ही होता है ना संस्कृत, दिस इज द करेक्ट, सबसे साइंटिफिक है संस्कृत. दैट इज व्हाई देयर इज अ यू नो ऑल दोज प्रोग्राम्स विच आर मेड इन द यू नो जावा एंड ऑल, दे ऑल फॉलो संस्कृत बिकॉज देर इज नो रूम फॉर एनी यू नो एक्सेप्शंस एंड रूल आउट्स एंड ऑल. सो नेक्स्ट वर्ड टेल मी वॉट इज द करेक्ट. हाँ यहाँ पे भी इसको आपको W को इग्नोर करना है, पूरी तरह से इग्नोर मारना है इसको, ठीक है, एज इफ कि वो है ही नहीं. तो आपको क्या बोलना है, sword, SAWD, sword. इट इज टू बी प्रोनाउंस एज sword, नॉट sword. भी कई लोग ऐसे बोलते हैं sword, वो भी नहीं बोलना, आपको इसको बोलना है sword, ठीक है. ये दिखने में बहुत इजी लगते हैं बट देन वंस यू विल करेक्ट देम एंड एकदम से इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू हैपन ओवरनाइट. यू विल हैव टू वर्क ऑन इट, यू विल हैव टू यू नो स्वेट ऑन इट, रियली आई एम टेलिंग यू. मेरा एक ही सजेशन है, नाउ द क्लास इज गोइंग टू वाइंड आउट, टेक अ स्क्रीन शॉट ऑफ दिस बिकॉज आई एम नॉट, आई डोंट हैव टाइम, आई हैव अनदर लेक्चर. टेक अ स्क्रीन शॉट ऑफ दिस एंड ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट वॉट इज द करेक्ट pronunciation of these words. Have you taken another one? Take one more. Done. One more. That's all. So try to find out the correct pronunciations of these words and you will make a difference. One second, I'm going to wind up this lecture. Okay. So, did you enjoy?
Yes, ma'am.
It's actually very interesting because, you know, this is something which you will be applying in your life. Every day, every moment you will be using this. I have changed so many pronunciation, right, from, you know, whatever is being fed to us, it is not our mistake also. Sometimes the family atmosphere is such that, you know, I belong to a Sikh family, so my mother used to always, you know, stress on a vowel. So, wo sab change karna. Now, if you hear me out, you will not be able to make out that I am from a Punjabi family and I'm just trying to stress out on certain word. I have worked on it, but still maybe ho sakta hai, somewhere I am still having those. Abhi Bengalis ka, they have a different accent, so you have to neutralize the accents. South Indians, they stress on different thing. Abhi Gujaratis hai, snacks bolna hota hai and they say snakes because unka A mein zyada stress hota hai. So you, what you will do, you will correct the pronunciation wherever you can do it. And it's a long journey. And this is not going to end in one lecture because you will keep on adding to the list. And aisa ek aap kar lo, that is going to benefit you a lot. A lot means really a lot. All those words jo aapne seekhe hain abhi tak aur jinka aap galat karte aaye ho, unko likh lo. And unka correct pronunciation bhi likh lo aur unko din mein char baar bolo. See, over the period of time, ekdam sahi ho jayega sab kuch. Theek hai? So now I'm wind up this lecture because I have another lecture at 9.